Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kamindu. So today in this short video we are going to discuss about how to identify and confirm another gram-positive bacteria. So let's talk about enterococci identification. Enterococci gram-positive spherical cells that occur in chains. Most of members in this group produce non-hemolytic or alpha-hemolytic colonies, which are often larger than that of other streptococci, and they grow well at 10 to 45 Celsius, but other streptococci grow at much narrower temperature range. Most of them cause diseases in hospitalized immunocompromised patients. They are part of normal enteric flora, but they can cause diseases in urinary tract and soft tissues adjacent to the intestinal flora. These diseases are not highly virulent and often mix with other intestinal flora. So let's discuss how to identify and confirm enterococci in laboratory. Always, if we go for diagnosis of particular infection, we are looking for clinical background, culture characteristic, then microscopy and biochemical and serological test. When we look at the growth of blood agar, enterococci species give small non-hemolytic colonies, but it may be alpha or beta hemolytic as well, and colonies are larger than other streptococci colonies. Growth on Meconium agar is important if we suspect streptococci species. Magenta color colonies can be seen on Meconium agar if it is belonging to enterococci species. Gram-positive cocci in chain can be seen if we correctly pick the enterococci colonies for smear preparation. Similar to other streptococci species, this one is also catalase negative. The special feature of enterococci species is that they can survive in bile and hydrolysis esculin. Therefore, we need to do bile esculin test if we suspect for enterococci. Some group D streptococci species can also give positivity in bile esculin test. So, to differentiate this, we can look for growth on 6.5% sodium chloride. Enterococci grow in 6.5% sodium chloride and thus show turbidity. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain knowledge about how to identify and confirm enterococci bacteria in laboratory. You can find this video script from our website www.aladdincreations.com. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.